An old adage is, with age comes wisdom. The truth is, it's more seasoning in life than anything that sort of helps us to remove the opportunities for strife. You see, the more experience you have relating to people in relationships of all kinds is a better opportunity to know what you need to do. Again, apologize that the stroke is sort of impacting my mouth, and that sort of happens to me of late. But isn't that great? It allows me to be humble because people have strokes every day. And I didn't know what that felt like. I didn't know what that experience was until I had that information today. But in the world of men, in the world of women, there is a certain amount of wit and wisdom. And the wit is the humility of laughing at ourselves, and the wisdom is knowing when not to, and when to push forward with a young person to teach them a lesson, to provide them a moral high ground, and to basically saying, you are screwing your life because you're not listening to anyone around you. Now, the truth is that our whole society has been founded on the art of discussion, the art and truth of discord. And if you don't understand the value of that, I strongly recommend you watch John Adams, which has a marvelous excerpt. It's like a three-part DVD video series. And it's really pretty amazing in terms of talking about what life was back then during the founding fathers of our Constitution and what it was like within their kind of petty wars and their impromptiness and the silliness of some of the attacks that they endured. But what it shows you is that America today isn't much different, which is really sad in some ways, because we do have racism, we do have ethnocentricity that abounds around us, and we do have people that are not the police that are more than willing to shoot you and me just because there's a difference in opinion. And that's not really okay today. We really should not be walking through the communities with weaponry is about 90% sure today, because there's always some immature person, especially in their 20s, that are ready to pull a gun on you today. And you're like, motherfucker, get out of my face. No one died and made you God to allow you to decide who's going to live and die today. The whole purpose of the Second Amendment is that we as a nation have the right to defend our life, our liberty, and our justice nation or cities. And what I mean by that is that it is our job to be just in our mind. It is our job to be at peace all the time. And it is our job to de-escalate situations before they get out of control and there's too many people involved and then we are too humiliated to do what's right. You see, your mouth is what puts you in front of people, and your mouth is what keeps you away from people. But your understanding of the importance of relationships is really something that's coming out of the gaming generation. The gaming generation says, I can just sit in my home and make a living and do my gaming shit all the time. And what it's doing is what I noticed about a young girl named Jane is that she was actually staying up late gaming and going to work late all the time. I thought, okay, there's an immaturity problem, because that is not going to get you a job in the future. And your important people that you're doing this internship with or you're getting paid by is not going to get you the accolade you need to get the next job that could go flying by if you're not given the right reporting. And the right reporting is the data. How many times a week does she show up late? How many times a week is she here early? How often does she do her job successfully? How long does it take her to perform her duties? You see, that's actually just a function of any human being's performance. You see, there are standard ways that we evaluate employee performance across the land. Regardless of what the industry is, regardless of what the position is, there are standard aspects of asking those questions. At the same time, within the overall kind of training matrix of a corporation or a manufacturing plant, there is really specific details of, does this person know how to correctly handle this particular product, this particular stamping, this particular value to our company? And something that people are not valuing are the products that are built in America or the ones that we're importing from overseas. Now, if you're someone who's living sort of above the poverty line, you're going to these quality shops that take care of us all the time. And everyone can value a great deal from the quality of products that are now showing up in the Dollar Trees and the Dollar Generals, and we really should be pleased that corporations are not discriminating in what they're trying to provide you in the quality and opportunities that you have in front of you. But they absolutely have the right to basically generalize the value of the product in terms of the volume that they distribute through those places. Now, I don't know if I'm waxing on too long, but something that corporate employees or company employees of national chains do not register, it's very, very important that you train to your employees and train to your family and train to your children, is that vending of product through these box type stores is the primary purpose of that position. That your job is to represent those multi-billion dollar internationally conglomerations of companies, basically, because think about PepsiCo. PepsiCo represents a lot of smaller companies and a lot of different brands. Some of them that you might consider in competition to one another, they're just another vended product that someone said, hey, let's make this and add this to our line. So I want to make it really clear to these young people going into retail establishment that you are representing not only the brand that you are putting your badge on for, but you are also representing millions of dollars of investment of products being put in your store that haven't quite yet been paid for.